his arm.
Yeah, can I get the mic back in a second? I'm just gonna have like some B-roll when I'm getting there. And then, are you going?
I'm gonna go get some food first.
Alright, well, yeah. When you get there, could you, would you be able to...
There's free popcorn at the theater.
I just need somebody to do the camera. I just need somebody to do camera on.
I
know, it's all good.
Hey, we're moving on now.
Be the champion.
Step up, man.
Check it.
Step up, man.
Step up. Step up, nigga.
Yo, step up. You in, man.
Yo.
Tell them who you is, man.
Yo, it's the West Coast shit talking B-boy from the 80s. Y'all niggas know the name. The game won't change. You heard it plenty of times. Said the enmity of rhymes. No need to repeat.
No.
This isn't to the beat. And you
see.
Final comic, so I want to ask for the huge hand for the man, the myth, the legend, Griffin Dabrowski.
Something up here.
Sorry.
Hi. My name's Griffin. I'm 19. I'm from Bloomington, Illinois. I'm just going to leave it here. It's going to record what I do now.
My show. Closing. Okay. You guys are making me anxious. You're not laughing. I feel like I'm being bullied right now. You guys are looking at me like I'm a big bird if he operated a Polish sausage factory in Chicago. Or a snuffleupagus going through chemo. Either way. I was driving earlier. Any of you guys drive?
Yeah,
where my driver's at. And I had to borrow a friend's car. It was a van, actually. Like one of those white ones with no windows. And it'll get to that in a second, don't worry. But I had to drive home. Everything was going all right. And then I reached a school zone, and I was like, ugh, school zone, am I right, ladies? So anyways, I look at the clock, and it's 4 p.m., so I'm like, I remember driver's ed, right? At 4 p.m. is when the school day's over, you can drive the speed limit, so I'm like, yeah. And so then I see a kid. And the sign also says when children are present, so I'm like, he's present, I'm not gonna slow down. But then, I see a cop behind the school, and I'm like, ooh, cause he sees this kid too. And I'm like, this kid's definitely here as bait for this cop. This complex speed trap he set up. But I have to make a decision. Either I speed up and just deal with the regular speed limit and risking a speeding ticket, or I slow down and risk looking like I'm trying to pick up a child in my van with no windows. So I had to think fast, and so I just stopped the van, got out, picked up the kid, threw him in the back, and drove the fuck away from there. Speeding, by the way. Yeah, I still don't feel like you guys don't get me. You guys don't know me that well. Like, I don't know, maybe you are like me. How about, if you are like me, have you ever been watching Gremlins with your friends? Hi, and about an hour into Gremlins, you start coming down. They haven't, but you realize you've just been watching My Wife and Kids with the lesser-known Wayans brother for an hour. But they're still high, so you can't tell them that because they think they're still watching Gremlins. Now, yeah, you're not like me then. Another thing that, not another thing I hate. I didn't say anything I hate yet, but something I hate jargon. Jargon stinks. Am I right, ladies? Jargon. Because jargon's like always flawed. I have a few examples. Three, because, you know, comedy. Three. So, one, never go to bed angry. That's stupid. You know why? It's just made up by old people. Because when old people go to sleep, sometimes they die. I'm not making this stuff up, guys. Read a book. Next jargon, butter me up. You're just trying to butter me up. That's also weird and gross. If you ever try to butter a human being, that's not gonna get them to do anything for you. Probably cause more problems. Ridiculous. And the third, April showers bring May flowers. Mm-mm, false. Not true at all. And it really makes me mad, because if the pieces of shit who came up with that phrase ever visited a nursery or talked to a fucking botanist, they would understand that flowers are living things with minds of their own, and they grow when they damn please. You guys haven't talked to botanists, clearly. Botanists, am I right, ladies? Let's see here. I have a friend who he refuses to watch porn, right? And I'm sure some of you are like, okay, whatever. Here's the catch. He masturbates religiously still. You know, like a serial killer. Like, I don't get how you can just do that like regularly without anything there, because what I imagine happens is he comes home from a long night of fun at a party, goes into the shower, into the corner, and Becky, and that party, oh, fuck, the long hair, that short skirt, I'm gonna fucking cut her body up and eat her. That's what that is. That's what that means. Jeffrey Dahmer did it. Well, I'm gonna close you guys with one more thing. Close you guys off here. It's a quote from your host and my good pal Jay Avery. Now, I don't know the context of this quote, but I had it written in my phone. And I'm just gonna say it, you know. This is Jay Avery, everybody. Griffin. I will get you a toaster oven if you can get me a girlfriend. Jay Avery. Thank you, guys.
If anyone's buying anyone a toaster oven to help them get a girl, you know it's Griffin. Look at him.